there are multiple commercial molecular platforms out there. And as practicing oncologists, we're very busy. We don't always want to delve into the details of particular tests, but unfortunately, it actually is quite relevant towards the results you're going to get and how you're going to use them for your patients. When looking at tests and comparing them to each other, what you need is a test that has good operating characteristics, so good sensitivity and specificity, especially for the common FDA-approved actionable changes. And you need the breadth of testing, that you're going to cover everything that you can action with an FDA-approved therapeutic, that you believe to be actionable through an off-label drug, or that you have availability of a clinical trial for the patient, including thinking about the patient's ability to travel, which would induce a need for broader testing. There are many commercial platforms out there that do this well. The most commonly used test in the United States is probably the Foundation Medicine test. It's a good panel. It's good sequencing. It's good bioinformatics. It catches all of the common stuff and most of the rare stuff. And I do like the way that they format their report. They format their report in a way that helps you to know what to do with it and makes it easy to find additional information.
One thing I like a lot about tumor mutation burden testing as I identify patients with non-small cell lung cancer is that I can get tumor mutation burden along with all the other molecular markers I care about. So in the tests that I use to identify patients with EGFR mutations, ALK gene rearrangements, ROS1 rearrangements, we get tumor mutation burden as a consequence of that. And so it's all rolled into one assay, which I think is really appealing.
Another question that arises is the turnaround time for next generation testing. In reality, that turnaround time is about 3 weeks. That's a long time for a lung cancer patient. In 3 weeks, lung cancer can grow, causing symptoms and even risking death. And so it's a big deal. And so there's a certain friction in clinical practice between wanting to do something right away to protect the patient and between wanting to wait and do the right thing. And I think that there are tough decisions that patient and doctor have to make together around this. In my practice, the two core elements that go into that conversation with the patient about whether to treat right away and whether to wait or whether to wait are the risk level of the disease and the probability of finding something useful on testing. So at one extreme, a patient with bulky central chest disease causing respiratory symptoms, pain, I might feel that I can't wait, that I need to treat right away, and then I reserve the right to change things as the molecular report comes back. But in contrast, a less symptomatic patient, and at this other extreme, maybe one with a high probability of having an actionable molecular change, for example, a never smoker, most of these changes, not all of them, but most are much more common in never smokers, or for example, EGFR mutation, the most common actionable change is statistically far more common in Asian women than in men or people of non-Asian race, right? So if you have those characteristics with a high probability of finding something actionable, and I have a patient whose disease status is such that I think they can afford to wait a little bit, then it's absolutely worth waiting for all the human advantages of targeted therapy when available.
In using tumor mutation burden as a predictive biomarker, one advantage is that it has an absolute score. So you know, there's different algorithms at Rutgers CINJ where we're typically calculating tumor mutation burden, or tumor mutation burden is calculated from a Foundation Medicine test. And so you know, we base it on that, but we have absolute well-defined cutoffs with the tumor mutation burden from Foundation One and good results or clinical data, supporting who potentially is going to respond or not respond based on their tumor mutation burden score. The turnaround time for tumor mutation burden, it's typically about 2 weeks. So, we're sending for this Foundation One assay, and it's typically a turnaround time of about 2 weeks, whereas PD-L1 immunohistochemistry is somewhere closer to 3 days.